Hi dear children, today we are going to discuss the very important section of this chapter, that is Bayes' theorem. The first subsection of this chapter is partition of a sample space. Partition of a sample space. A set of events E1, E2, etc. En, a set of events E1, E2, etc. Em is said to represent a partition of the sample space S. E1, E2, etc. En is said to represent a partition, of the sample space S if that should satisfy three conditions. The first one is EI intersection EJ is equal to phi. EI intersection EJ is equal to phi. I not equal to J, I comma J is equal to 1, 2, etc. N. EI intersection EJ is equal to phi, comma I not equal to J, I comma J is equal to 1, 2, etc. N. That means, if you took the intersection of any two events, that should be is equal to phi. Okay. E1 intersection E2, is there any common element? No. So, that is equal to phi. Similarly, E5 intersection E3, there is no common element. So, if you took any two events and the intersection of that events should be is equal to phi. The second one, E1 union, E2 union, etc. union, En is equal to S. E1 union, E2 union, etc. union, En is equal to S. That means, if you took the union of all these events, that should be is equal to a sample space. Okay. The last one, P of EI greater than 0. P of EI greater than 0 for all I is equal to 1, 2, etc. N. P of EI, that means the probability of all these events should be greater than 0. Some elements should be there in our E1, E2, etc. En. That means E1 not equal to phi, E2 not equal to phi, E3 not equal to phi, etc. En not equal to phi. Okay. So if our events E1, E2, etc. En satisfies these three conditions, then we can say that this is the partition of our sample space. Okay, this is the partition of our sample space. Okay, actually, if EI intersection EJ is equal to phi, EI intersection EJ equal to phi, we will say that that two events are disjoint events. EI intersection EJ is equal to phi, then we can say that that two events are disjoint events. Okay, if the intersection of any two events is equal to phi, then that two events are disjoint events. Now, the second section of this theorem of total probability. Theorem of total probability. Theorem of total probability. Okay. Let E1, E2, etc. En be a partition of the sample space. Okay. This is a partition. E1, E2, etc. En. That is the partition of our sample spaces. And suppose that each of the events E1, E2, En has non-zero probability. That means it should satisfy the third condition of partition. Let A be any event associated with S. Suppose this is our A. A be any event associated with our sample space. Suppose this is our A. A be any event associated with the sample space S. Now we need to find out the probability of getting A. probability of getting A. For that, this A we can write it as A intersection S, right? Because this A is the subset of our S, then A intersection S, we will get it as A itself. And this is equal to A intersection. It is given that this E1, E2, etc., EN are the partition of our sample space. Then it should satisfy the second condition of partition. That is, E1 union, E2 union, etc. union, EN is equal to S. So this S we can replace it by E1 union, E2 union, etc. union, EN, right? Now, A distributive law, A intersection E1 union, A intersection E2 union, etc. A intersection EN, etc. union, A intersection EN. Now just look at this Venn diagram. What is A intersection E1? A intersection E1, we will get this portion, right? This is our A intersection E1. And what is A intersection E2? This is the common portion for A and E2. Now, my question is, A intersection E1 and A intersection E2, is there any elements common? For A intersection E1 and A intersection E2, is there any common element? No. Common element means intersection, right? This is equal to 5. A intersection E1, intersection A intersection E2 is equal to 5. Okay, that means all the elements, all the events in this expression that is disjoint. Okay, A intersection E1, intersection A intersection E2, we got it as 5. That means this A intersection E1 and A intersection E2 are disjoint events. Okay, now take probability on both sides. P of A is equal to P of A intersection E1 union A intersection E2 union, etc. union, A intersection EN. Okay. Now, we know that P of A union B is equal to, what is P of A union B? P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B, right? Now, if this A and B are disjoint events, if this A and B are disjoint events, then this P of A union B is equal to P of A plus P of B. Because if A and B are disjoint events, then A intersection B equal to 5. If A intersection B equal to 5, then that probability equal to 0. So if A and B are disjoint events, then P of A union B is equal to P of A plus P of B. Now we are going to use this. We have P of A is equal to P of A intersection E1 union A intersection E2 union etc. union A intersection EN. That is P of A is equal to P of A intersection E1 plus P of A intersection E2 plus etc. plus P of A intersection EN. P of A intersection EN. So P of A is equal to P of A intersection E1 plus P of A intersection E2 plus etc. plus P of A intersection EN. Now, what is our multiplication theorem? Multiplication theorem P of A intersection, multiplication theorem, it says that P of A intersection EI is equal to P of EI into P of A given EI. P P of A intersection EI is equal to P of EI into P of A given EI, provided P of EI not equal to 0, provided P of EI not equal to 0. This is our multiplication theorem. Okay, now we are going to use multiplication theorem here. Then what you will get? P of A is equal to, first one is P of A intersection E1, that is P of E1 into P of A given E1 plus. Second one is A intersection E2, that is P of E2 into P of A given E2 plus etc. plus P of En into P of A given En. Okay. P of En into P of A given En. Thus we can write it by using sigma notation. That is P of A is equal to summation j is equal to 1 to n P of Ej into P of A given Ej. P of A is equal to summation j is equal to 1 to n P of Ej into P of A given Ej. This is called theorem of total probability. This is a theorem of total probability. So if E1, E2, etc., En are the partitions of our sample space and A be any event associated with S, then P of A is equal to summation j is equal to 1 to n P of Ej into P of A given Ej. Now, second one, Bayes theorem. First theorem is theorem of total probability, and the second one is Bayes theorem. In this theorem, we are going to find out the probability of getting one of our partition. Okay. If E1, E2, etc., En are n non-empty events which constitute a partition of sample space S, then P of EI given A, P of EI given A we need to find. P of EI given A. This we need to find. Here actually we need to find out the probability of one of our partition member, right? We need to find out the probability of one of our partition member. But in that theorem of total probability, actually we need to find the probability of an event. Okay. Here this is our event A. This is our partition member. EI is our partition member, A is our event. If you want to find out the probability of event, then we will use theorem of total probability. And if you want to find out the probability of one partition member, then we will use Bayes theorem. Clear? If you want to find the probability of an event, okay, like A, then we will use theorem of total probability. And if you want to find the probability of the one partition member, then we will use Bayes theorem. Clear? Here we need to find P of EI given A, and this is by using multiplication theorem, conditional probability P of A intersection EI divided by P of A, right? P of EI given A is equal to P of A intersection EI divided by P of A. Clear? And this is equal to A intersection EI. This is by conditional probability. Conditional probability. Now in numerator we are going to apply multiplication theorem. That is P of EI into P of A given EI, right? P of EI into P of A given EI divided by P of A. This is by multiplication theorem. Now, in denominator, we are going to use theorem of total probability. That is P of EI into P of A given EI all divided by P of A. What is our P of A by using theorem of total probability? That is summation j is equal to 1 to n P of EJ into P of A given EJ. P of EJ into P of A given EJ. This is by using theorem of total probability. Okay. So, P of EI given A, we need to find the probability of getting one of our partition member after the occurrence of our event. So, after the occurrence of our event A, so this is conditional probability. So, we will use the definition of conditional probability, that is P of A intersection EI divided by P of A. Now, in numerator, we will apply multiplication theorem. P of EI into P of A given EI. In denominator, we can apply theorem of total probability. So, we will get P of EI given A is equal to P of EI into P of A given EI divided by summation j is equal to 1 to n P of EJ into P of A given EJ.